Hello again, everyone, and welcome back to Learn Linux TV, and also welcome back to the Linux Crash Course series here on Learn Linux TV. In this series, I teach you a valuable Linux skill one video at a time, and unless I let you guys know otherwise, each video in the series can be watched in any order. Today's video brings us to the passwd command. The passwd command, short for password, can help you change, well, your password. Now, it's not as simple as just that, though, because there's some additional tricks up its sleeve as well. Maybe even some things that you didn't even know if you're already familiar with the command. Now, what I'm going to do is give you some hands-on examples in this video that are going to teach you everything you need to know about the passwd command. But before we get to that, I need to take a moment and mention the sponsor for this video, Akamai Connected Cloud. If you're looking for a cloud provider that's affordable, flexible, and reliable, then look no further than Akamai Connected Cloud. With Akamai's cloud platform, you can spin up Linux servers quickly, and the platform contains all the features you'll need to deploy full-featured solutions. And using the marketplace, you could easily deploy applications such as Nextcloud, RocketChat, Mastodon, WordPress, Pi-hole, Plex, Jenkins, and many more. In fact, there's over 100 applications available in the marketplace. If you want to set up a custom Linux instance, you could do that too. All the popular Linux distributions are available on the platform, including, but not limited to, Debian, CentOS, Fedora, Ubuntu, and many others. In fact, even Arch Linux is available. So check out Akamai Connected Cloud with the URL that you see on the screen right now, which will do two things. First, it'll help support this channel, which I'll really appreciate, and it'll also get you $100 in starter credit to check out the platform. And thank you so much to Akamai for sponsoring today's video. I really appreciate it. Now, with all of that out of the way, let's dive into the passwd command. Let's start with basic usage. And basic usage of the passwd command is fairly simple. All you have to do is type passwd, just like that. And once you press enter, what it's going to do is ask you for your current password. So I'll type that in right now. Next, it wants me to choose my new password, so I'll type that in right now. And again. And take a look at that. I was able to change my password. Now, a couple of things to note about this command before we go further. Right now, I'm logged in as user J. When I ran the passwd command, I didn't specify a user. And if you don't specify a user, what's going to happen is it's going to default to the user that you're currently logged in as. You can use the passwd command to change the password for other users, but we'll get to that shortly. Now, in that simple example, all we did was change our password. So if you didn't already know how to change your password on your Linux system, well, now you know. However, the usefulness of the passwd command doesn't end there. Another trick that I want to show you guys is how to view statistics regarding your password. And to do that, what we'll do is type passwd, and then I'll give it the option dash capital S. And for this, I will need to specify a username, so I'll just use mine for an example. However, it's not going to work. It's telling me that only root can do that. And the reason for that is because anything outside of changing your own password, for the most part, is going to require root privileges. So I could just log in as root to execute that command, but more simply, what I'll do is just prefix the command with sudo, just like that. And now, let's see what happens. And here we have some information regarding my user's password. But what exactly does this information mean? Well, the first field is my username, so no surprise there. I mean, I literally typed the username J, so we see J right there at the beginning. After that, I have PS shown next to my username. And in that case, this means that I have a usable password. On some distributions, that might just be P instead of PS, but it essentially means the same thing. If I didn't have a password, I would have NP here, and I would also have an L here for a locked password. And that could also be shown as LP as well. We're actually going to visit locking passwords, so I'm not going to focus so much on that field right now. Now, if you're at all confused with what's in that field for your user account, what you could do is just check the man page for the passwd command, and then I'll type slash, dash capital S, enter, that's activating search, and then I'll press N, and that's going to bring me to the next occurrence. And right here, we see a description for what the fields mean in the passwd command. Now, I'm going to explain these to you, but pay special attention to where it says has no password, np, locked password, lk, and so on. And perhaps you might have to consult this if the information shown in that field is different for you than what I show on mine. But all in all, that field tells you whether your password is usable, whether you have a password at all, or if the password is locked. We will be seeing how to lock a password shortly, so I'm not going to worry about that part for right now. So let's move on. The third field is the date of the last password change for my user. And actually, I'm recording this video on the 29th, and it's showing that my password changed on the 29th. Is that a coincidence? Well, not really. That's showing the most recent password change there in that field. Now, continuing on from there, the next several fields all have to do with password expiration. Unless your organization has a password change policy or you've enabled password expiration, then you shouldn't really have any limitations here unless you impose them yourself, or if your system administrator, if that's not you, imposed limitations. The zero, in this case, is the minimum password age, which refers to how old the password has to be in order for me to be allowed to change it again. Right now it's set to zero, which means I could change my password again whenever I please. If I had 3 here, for example, then that means 3 days must pass before I'm allowed to change my password again. Again, a value of 0 means that I could change my password whenever I want to. For the fifth field, in my case, we have a series of 9s. And these 9s all have to do with days, specifically how many days have to pass until I need to change my password again. If you see all 9s like I do, then that means the password never expires. After that, we have 7. And this field refers to the number of days prior to a password expiring in which the user will start to see password expiration warnings. Finally, the last field, which is -1 in my case, refers to how many days after password expiration that the account will become locked out. That's not relevant in my case because there's no expiration set for my password. So far in this video, we've been working with our own user account when it comes to the passwd command. However, the passwd command can be used with other user accounts as well, so let's see that in action. And to help with the examples that I'm about to give you, I'm going to create another user account that we could work with for these examples. So I'll type sudo and then user add. I've gone over creating and managing users in another video in this series. In fact, I'll leave a card for one of those videos right here. Anyway, I typed sudo and then user add. I want to add a user. And what should I call the user account? Well, what I'm going to do is name the user Voltron, because if we can have Voltron log into our server, that would be an honor. Anyway, I'll press enter to create that user. And now the user should exist. In fact, we can see it there at the end with UID 1001 and group ID 1001. So I've successfully created a user. And if I want to switch to that user, I could type su and then hyphen, followed by the username. However, there's a problem. It wants me to type the password, but I never set a password for this user. So no matter what I enter in here, it's not going to work. And this is another example where the passwd command comes in handy. So just like before, I'll type passwd. However, I will need to prefix the command with sudo. And the reason for that is because I intend to work with a user account that's not my own. I want to set a password for Voltron, so I'll press enter. Now notice that it's not asking me for Voltron's current password. And it's not because I haven't set one. If I was to log in as Voltron, if Voltron already had a password, then I would be asked for the current password. But when you use sudo with passwd, you are running passwd as root, and root doesn't need permission to change someone's password. It just allows you to do it. So it jumps right ahead to allowing you to set the new password. So I'll type that in right here. And again. And now Voltron has a password. And due to that, if I want to switch to Voltron, I'm going to be asked for Voltron's password, of course, but the user has a password now. So I will be able to answer that prompt. And just like that, I was able to log in to that particular account with a password that I created using the passwd command. How cool is that? Anyway, I'll log out. And now I'm back to my user account. Sorry to interrupt myself, but I just wanted to let you know that I really enjoy making this content for you guys. I have a ton of fun. If you enjoy the content that I produce, then please consider supporting Learn Linux TV. The thing is, producing content like this isn't cheap. So by giving back to the channel, you can help me make even more content for you guys. And to find out more about how you can support Learn Linux TV, what you could do is go to support.learnlinux.tv, and there you'll find some of the ways that you can help support the channel. Anyway, let's get back to the video. Now, let's say that Voltron is actually up to no good. That probably would never happen, but let's go along with it. Let's say we want to lock Voltron's password. So if we want to lock a password for a user, we of course type sudo and then passwd. And what we'll do is add dash l for lock, and then the name of the user we want to, well, lock. So I'll type in the user right here and I'll press enter. And here it's telling me that it's locking the password for that user and it was a success. And going back to one of the earlier examples, passwd-s allows us to view statistics around a user's password. And again, if I was to just end the command right here, it's going to default to my user, but I want to view the statistics for Voltron, so I'll press enter right here. And in the second field, we have LK. That refers to a locked password. That account is currently locked. And due to that, if I wanted to switch to that user, I'll type in the password yet again. And it tells me authentication failure. Well, I've locked the account, so of course I'm not able to log into it. And to reverse that decision, I'll type sudo passwd-u for unlock, and then the username. And if I check the statistics yet again, we can see that the user has a usable password. It has PS there in the second field. It previously had LK for lock, so I have unlocked the password for that user. Now, next, what we're going to do is take a look at expiration. But how do we add an expiration date to the password? Well, what I'm going to do is recall the previous command here. That way we have output before we make the change. And what I'll do is start the command just like before. And then I'll add the dash X option. And then after that, I'll type the number of days from now in which I want the password to expire. So let's say, for example, I want the password to expire in 30 days. And then after that, of course, I type the username that I want this to apply to. It tells me that the change was successful. And notice how the field that previously had all nines in it now has, well, 30. So the password will expire in 30 days. But what if I wanted the password to expire right now? I don't want to wait. I want to expire it right now. Well, what I could do is add the dash E option for expire, and that'll make the password expire immediately. And immediately we can see something strange here. We have the date of December 31st, 1969. Now I can personally assure you that the year is not currently 1969. You'll have to trust me on that. It's actually 2023 as I record this video. But we can see a change right here. The password expires in 30 days. Well, 30 days from 1969 has absolutely passed. So I think we can rest assured that this account has expired. And yet another option that I want to show you guys here, since we're going through all of the expiration related options, is the dash D option. And what that does is delete the password for the user. It'll literally make the user have no password at all. Let's enter it and check the status yet again. And notice how the second field now says no password, or NP for short. The user no longer has a password at all. Now you might be wondering, why would I delete the user's password instead of just lock them out? Well, here's the difference. If we lock the account, we can't use it. Now, of course, if we have sudo privileges, we could do whatever we want to. But watch what happens when I use su, and then I type the name of the user just like we did before. I didn't add sudo or anything like that, but I was able to log right in as that user. And that's what deleting the password enabled me to do. I could still use the account. The account has no password. Now, obviously, if there's a security concern, you definitely want to lock the account. You wouldn't want a crypto miner to be using the account, for example, or some other malicious piece of software. So it's recommended to lock the account if it's a security concern. But I wanted to give you the -d option to make sure that you understood that you can also delete a user's password with the passwd command. And, well, there's our video. In this video, I gave you examples of the passwd command in action, and this is one of the shorter videos in this series, but it's an important one because the passwd command is one that you should certainly know. I hope this video was helpful for you guys. If it was, please consider clicking that like button to let YouTube know that you liked this video. In the meantime, I have some awesome content coming that I can't wait for you guys to see, so make sure that you subscribe to Learn Linux TV for the latest in Linux, and I'll see you in the next video.